Praise the Lord. We're on the Trenton Internet, Facebook, whatever you want to call it, coming to you from Trenton, Michigan. We're so thankful that we're the Church of God that have good news. And the good news is that Jesus still saves.
Yes, yes.
And we are preached the cross, death, burial, and resurrection of Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
Soon coming. We hope you enjoy our program as Don comes and sings a couple of good gospel songs. You need to order these tapes from me. I'll tell you what, they'll do you good in your car, in your home. When you're down, they'll lift you up. I was going to ask you to sing God Bless America again on the internet. And you don't have it with you now, do you? You don't have it. Okay, well, sing what you want to.
Amen.
Amen.
Good evening, everybody.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Oh, come on. You can do better than that now.
Amen.
Good evening, everybody.
Good evening.
All right.
Yes. This song is new to me.
Amen.
Sister Woods, please stand up, face the camera, and say something for the Lord.
Thank the Lord. Well, I guess I get tired of this. But anyway, how many of us are glad to be here?
Thank you, Lord.
I thank God that I'm able, Sister Hayes, to be in the house
Amen.
Of God.
Amen.
I thank him for what he's meant to me. I was raised up in a Church of Christ. My mom and dad was Church of Christ people. But I knew there was more to it and what we were getting. And so I went to a revival when that Church of God Prophecy revival out in the opening. And a woman went up to get the Holy Ghost. And it wasn't too many there, but she said, somebody come and pray with her. And I went and prayed with her. And I said, should I go pray with her then when I don't have the Holy Ghost myself? But I was obedient to God. Obedience is better than sacrifice.
Yes.
Amen.
And I was obedient, and I went and prayed with her. And when I got back to the seat, I was speaking in other tongues as the Spirit I never forget it. As I was going home, my mouth felt so odd. The Holy Ghost had come through. But I thank him tonight for his mighty power and his mighty act. I thank him for my family. I got a good family. And I just love him tonight, and I want to get closer to God. I really do.
Praise God.
Amen.
And
this next song I'm going to sing, here in the church, I want each and every single one of us to close our eyes, clear all your thoughts, and out there in the internet who's listening, I want you to close your eyes, clear your thoughts, and just get your mind on the Lord. If you want to, you can raise your hand.
This is the air I breathe.
Yes.
This is the air I breathe. Your holy presence living in me.
Yes, you're my daily bread.
This is my daily bread. were lost without you.
Almighty God.
This is the air I breathe.
Oh, thank you, Lord.
Oh, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, because you are the air that
we breathe. Yes, mighty God.
You are the air that we read each and every day to lift your name up on high, to bring you all the glory and all the honor.
Yes.
Each and every time, with each breath, we lift your name up on high. Oh, thank you, Lord.
All right, praise God. Oh, I love that song. You're going to have to sing that more often. Amen.
Yes.
I'm as glad to be in the house of the Lord.
Amen.
You could be in the Lord. You could be in prison. Amen. But God has blessed us. You know, if we would count our blessings, then outweigh everything if we complain about. God brought the wrath upon the people of Israel because of their murmuring, complaining. We don't have like other nations, they said. We don't have a king. They wanted the king when it wasn't God's will for them to have a king. He was their king. And because of their hardness of heart, he gave him permission for Saul, and he turned out bad and committed suicide. Broke the laws of God. God knows what he's doing. We don't. Amen. Now, I love the scripture that tells us, if we be Christus, then we're Abraham's seeds and theirs according to the promise. I told the Lord, I said, Lord, I'm yours.
Amen.
I'm yours. And I mean that.
Yes.
When I knelt that old-fashioned altar and prayed of the Lord, here I am and all I ever hoped to be, I'm putting on the altar for you. That's been many, many years ago. And I'm still going after 50-some years.
Thank you, Lord.
I just might be the oldest pastor in the Church of God right now in the state of Michigan. I don't know. But, amen. Somebody said, I ain't going to get into it. But if we be Christ's, then we're Abraham's seeds and heirs according to the promise. Abraham's blessing is ours. We're blessed.
Yes, amen.
When we lie down, amen. The Bible says we're blessed when we get up. We're blessed when we go out. We're blessed when we come
yes,
in.
Yes, we are. Yes. Oh, thank
our baptism is blessed. The fruit of our body, our children, is supposed to be blessed. We're blessed. In the city, blessed in the field, the head, not the tail.
Amen.
Amen.
You don't have to go dragging around. You're above and not beneath.
Yes.
Thank God we're above
yes.
and
yes.
not beneath. If we keep the commandments of God,
yes.
none of these diseases will come up on you that I put up on the Egyptians.
Come on.
Amen.
That's where the Bible tells us that God is against sickness and disease.
Amen.
Adam and Eve committed it, high treason, sold the whole human race out, and all the problems of this world is because of their disobedience to God. Disobedience is sin. But Abraham came on the scene. He kept the commandments of God. He was a rich man. God ain't just riches. If money don't have you, it's good to have money as long as it don't have you.
That's right, amen.
But today people is not content unless they're trying to keep up with the Smiths and the Joneses. That's right. I'm not trying to keep up with anybody. I'm just
amen.
Trying to be content where I'm at. I've never asked God for riches. Oh, I've asked him maybe for a financial blessing or something like that. But I've never asked him to make me rich. Because we ain't got time to get rich, church.
Amen.
The day of the Lord is at hand.
Yes, it is. Amen.
And I'm looking for the coming of the Lord and the rapture of the church any moment. That will take place. This world is in reeling and rocking.
Amen.
And he's coming after a church without spots, without wrinkle, without blemish, and once blameless.
Amen.
Now,
yes.
Church, they got to be some improving in churches today. If he's coming without a church without spots or without blemish, and one that is blameless, they got to be some hard preaching. We used to have hard preaching.
Yes.
And people used to obey it. But now, you preach hard, they'll go find them another church that'll compromise. I will never compromise God's word.
Amen.
I'll call sins. A lot of people know what sin is. Sin is the trespasses of God's word. What he tells you in the word not to do, and you do it, then you break the law of God.
Amen.
This whole nation is guilty of breaking the laws of God.
Amen.
But I thank God tonight that we're not of the world. Aren't you glad you're not of the world?
That's
you're
right.
In the world, but you're
yes.
not of the world.
Yes.
Thank God. My name is written in the Lamb's Book of Life from the foundation of the world. Saved by the blood of Jesus Christ. Sanctified. Set apart.
Come on.
There's a lot of things that Christians can't do. But thank God there's blessings that those who keep the commandments of God. Mm-hmm. Sometimes things get rough, you know, get tough with us. Sometimes we go through these trials and tests. But he promised us to never leave us or forsake us.
Amen.
But he would go with us to the end of the world.
Yes.
Now, I don't know about you. I'm looking to be ready when the rapture takes place.
Yes, I am.
Amen.
I'm looking
Praise God. Sometimes we got to lay aside every weight and every sin. Run this race with patience, looking to Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith.
Yeah.
We haven't been apprehended yet. We've not made it yet. There's many things that we may have to go through before the Lord comes. I don't know. Nobody knows. But God knows.
Amen.
The hour in which we're living. And it don't look too good for America and for other nations too. Because these are trying times, and we all know that. I heard the other day where, I think I mentioned this in the pulpit before, where Congress has inquired of all this hallowed food that you turn and put water in and turn into whatever you want. Now that tells me something. If Congress is going to buy all that food out, that they know something is going to happen. I don't want to get into that and scare people and run people to the store and buy their groceries out.
Amen.
A lot of people get, you know, their shelves get empty and things like that, but let God lead you. But if we are the children of Abraham and sons and daughters of God, God said, I'll supply all of your needs according to his riches and glory by Christ Jesus. Now, not part of them, but all of our needs.
Amen.
He loadeth us daily with his benefits. God has great benefits, and I thank him for them every day I can.
Yes, amen.
Until we go to bed every night, quoting scripture. Hallelujah. Thank God.
Praise God.
Whosoever shall say, didn't say pray, said say, to this mountain. Could be a mountain of financial difficulties, a mountain of sickness. Be thou removed and cast into the sea, and shall not doubt in his heart, but believe those things that he saith shall come to pass. He shall have whatsoever he saith.
Yes.
Say amen, somebody.
Amen.
Amen.
The Bible tells us that God has already given us all things pertaining to life and to godliness.
Yes, he does.
What are we wanting for? The more some people get, the more they want. I've watched rich people. The more they get, the more they want.
Uh-huh.
Well, I don't have to worry about that, but there's one thing about it. I thank God for people that are blessed with money and knows how to care for it and take care of it.
Amen.
That's why God can't trust some people, you know?
Amen.
He can't trust some people with money. because they just buy everything that their eyes fall upon. But yet, we're blessed. Everybody say, I'm blessed.
I'm blessed.
I'm blessed in the city. I'm blessed in the field.
I'm blessed in the field.
I'm the head, not beneath.
I'm the head, not
beneath. I'm above, not beneath. I'm the head, not the tail.
Yeah.
Thank God. These blessings belong to the church.
Yes. Yes, they do.
And the church sometimes don't realize that, so they go to other sources. Some people don't know how to claim the promises of God. They are yours.
Yes.
Just like divine healing Jesus Christ paid for 2,000 years ago. And I think all the church needs to do is start taking that healing and claiming that healing.
Yes.
And I've done that for many years, and my body is still strong contrary to what anybody thinks. Amen. Praise the Lord. I've been through a lot, but God's brought me through every trial, every test, every storm of life. I wish I could tell you I've been perfect in this life, but I haven't, neither have you. We've all failed. The Bible says, now I'm not going to say all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. That was under the Old Testament. But the righteous will forsake sin and they will flee to God. Righteousness is of God. And the world tonight has gone so far that they no longer honor God, no longer keep the commandments, no longer hold to the unchanging hand of God. Men, Sister Wood sings a song sometimes. I can't walk without Him holding my hand.
Amen.
Neither can you. He said, without me, you can do nothing. But thank God with Him, we can overcome.
Yes.
We are overcomers by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of our testimony. The Bible tells us that we're not have to overcome. If we got a testimony and the word of God abiding within us, we're overcomers.
Yes.
We're not going under. We're going over to the other side.
Yes.
Thank God tonight for His word that dwells in us tonight. And I'll say this morning, this word, and we're the temple of God. Amen.
Amen.
Think about it. You're the temple. God dwells in here. This is His house.
Yes.
This building is not His house.
Yes. Hallelujah.
It's just brick and stone and things like that.
Yep.
Where will you make me a house that He wanted our bodies to be His house? So He dwells within us. And I thank God for it tonight. That's why He said, my sheep hear my voice, and a stranger they will not follow. It seemed to me like some people can't hear the voice of the Lord. Somebody said, well, if God never talks to me, but open the Bible and read it, and He'll talk to you.
Yes, He will.
Sometimes He talks with an audible voice. Sometimes He talks to you through the Word.
Amen.
Sometimes He gives you dreams. You know, I've had 3 visions since I've been saved. That's all. Thank God for them. Sometimes through a dream He can give you a warning. I got a warning one time. I got a snake that hit me 3 times. Didn't hurt me, though. Didn't hurt me a bit. And I got 3 telephone calls. I had to say, shut up and get off. Amen. The word of the Lord is forever settled in heaven. He watches over to perform it. It will never fail you. It will never fail me.
Amen.
But he'll accomplish that what He's pleased, where He's pleased to send it. Thank God that we are Abraham's seed, heirs of God and joint heirs with Jesus Christ. You think about that. We don't know that, do we? We're heirs of God and joint heirs with Jesus Christ, and the world don't even know it.
Praise God.
Pastors have told them they're nobody. You are a somebody if you're in the kingdom of God.
Yes, you are.
Don't let no preacher stand and tell you that you're not worthy, that you can't sing the song, I'm the righteousness of God. One fellow was singing that song, and the pastor came up and stopped and said, you can't sing that song. You know you're not righteous. He used the scripture of the Old Testament. We've all sinned, come short of the glory of God. We are the righteousness of God in Christ right now.
Yes, amen.
We're not going to be right, but we are righteous right now. by the blood of the Lamb of God, purified, sanctified, set apart. I said set apart from this world.
Thank you, Lord.
We're in it, but we're not of it. Thank God for the blood. I know they don't want to talk about the blood anymore. They call it a slaughterhouse religion. I'm preaching to the world. Now, y'all heard me preach it many times, but I'm preaching to the world out there. And you need to know the truth, and the truth will make you free.
Amen.
Set you free. I'm free tonight. Yes. And he that is free indeed. Yes. I'm not in bondage to nobody. Thank God. I'm not in bondage to sin no longer. It cannot lord it over you. Neither can it lord it over me. We have power. What do you think God gave us the power for? The Holy Ghost for? He is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we may think or ask, according to the power that worketh in us. Wow! We got the Holy Ghost working for us. Yeah. In us tonight.
Yeah.
In us tonight. We got authority.
Yes.
Holy Ghost authority.
Yes.
Right.
Preachers don't even mention Holy Ghost anymore. They're so dignified and sophisticated, you can't figure them out. Hallelujah. But I'm glad tonight that God knocked all the starch out of me many years ago. When I first started preaching, I started preaching like this.
Amen.
I'll tell you, I was on fire for God. I want to burn. I want my shirt tail to burn for him, praise God.
Yes.
He said, I'll make my ministers a flaming fire. My angels minister in spirits. They minister for us and deliver us. You ever get to a place, you ever call for an angel? They can be dispatched to come to your rescue because they're ministering spirits for us. I know that I've had angels to protect me in 3 different car total loss car wrecks, bar fights, I know it isn't all that, but I know that the angel of God has protected me. And I know my old Church of God praying grandmother in the state of West Virginia prayed that God would make me a minister. She had 5 grandsons preaching the gospel. I guess I'm the only one alive now. Preaching the gospel. They may be one more. But I'm so thankful tonight that I had somebody praying for me.
Yes.
Watching
yes.
over me. Amen. The prayers of the righteous availeth much. You know that?
Amen.
Seeking you'll find. Knock and it shall be opened. That's what he promised us.
Yes, amen.
We are children of the Most High God, bought with the blood of Jesus Christ. The devil don't have nothing to do with you if you're full of the Holy Ghost and power. I mean, when you meet him, he trembles.
Yes.
He wants to get away from you.
Ooh, yes.
Come on, somebody say amen. You know I'm telling you the truth.
Amen.
The devil don't want to be around somebody that's full of God.
Yes.
Because he knows he's going to get casted out.
Yep. Amen.
We've had that happen right here in this church. We've had the devil casted out here a few years back. I'm sorry to say we ain't had no more since then. I don't guess we have. You never know. Thank God that thing come out. Even the doctor told this sister that you look 10 years younger. She made one little mistake. That's all the devil wants you to do. Make one little mistake.
Yep.
She left a pint of whiskey in the drawer. Her and her husband had a little argument and she went and got that whiskey. Never could stop it again. She tried. She comes, she called me every night or two. Counsel with her, pray for her. Never would overcome it. Died. Her head became as yellow as a pumpkin. Her liver eaten up. Friends, I'm going to tell you, you don't play with sin.
Amen.
You don't play with fire either.
Amen.
There's people that play with fire, you're going to get burnt when you play with it. Amen. But God is calling out a called out people. We are a called out people. I said a while ago, yes, we're in this world. But we are not part of it. We don't take no part with the sins. We don't go where the world goes. Or I don't. It seems like some Christian thinks it's all right to go some of these honky-tonks and all the places like that. One preacher tried that. He tried that years ago, going into the bars and trying to win the sinners and getting permission from the manager to preach. Finally, he picked up a woman. Dave Wilkerson sent him on an airplane, stuck his finger under his nose and said, "You're to blame." He was drinking alcohol and with this woman. He lost a ministry. I've never heard, well, I've heard from him since then. But there was a boy that came up to him in a bar. I mean, he was in the bar after he backslid. And this boy came up to him and said, "Would you pray for me?" Said, "My mother's a Pentecostal," and said, "I need prayer. Will you pray for me?" That's what got him back to the Lord. That worked on his heart. He got on his knees and accepted the Lord back out, but nobody would ever use him. He was doing a great work for the Lord. Nobody would use him after that. All the churches. And sometimes I think when somebody repents and truly repents, we ought to forgive them as God forgives. If we don't forgive them in
one
that makes mistakes and sin, and they really truly come back to the Lord and ask forgiveness and get forgiveness, I think that we ought to have enough of grace of God in our heart to love them and to forgive them.
Amen.
And to work for them and work as they did before. But a lot of people don't see that. The grace of God is sufficient for to meet every need. If we will trust Him. Trust in the Lord with all thine heart and lean not to thy own understanding. Your understanding will get you in trouble. Your understanding will tell you, you can do this, you can do that, and get by with it. You cannot hoodwink God.
Amen.
He sees everything you do. He knows everything you do.
Amen.
And He's willing tonight to forgive when we confess that we have made a mistake or even if we have sinned. Sometimes people don't realize that sometimes they got hidden sins, secret sins. I ask God to forgive me every time that I pray, if I have. Maybe I've said something against somebody. Maybe I've talked about somebody. Maybe I've judged somebody.
Yeah, anything.
Maybe I've run somebody down. Maybe I've tried to find out about people. What are they doing? And calling other people and accepting what they're saying. We should never believe anybody that will talk about another person.
Amen.
We should never ask them, "Did you hear about so-and-so? God hates sowing discord. He hates it worse than adultery." And a lot of times we're so discord. We ask somebody, "Did you hear about that person? I heard about them. Do you know what they done?" And the first thing you know, you got gossip going.
Yep.
Next thing you know, that person's name has been slandered. You can kill people with your tongue.
Yes,
the tongue is full of deadly poison, set on fire of hell.
Come on.
And people, unruly,
amen.
James tells us. And we need to learn not yet hung by the tongue. You can get hung by the tongue.
Amen.
Watch what you say. Watch what you talk about.
That's right.
Let your conversation be yea or nay. Amen.
Amen.
And we judge people. That's another thing that God's not pleased with. Mm-hmm. I don't know your heart. You don't know my heart. The only way I can tell you if I see you bearing bad fruit.
That's true.
You shall know them by their fruit they bear. Now, if we're bearing fornication and things like that, they've already been judged. I don't have to judge them. God's done judged them. So watch what you say. Realize that God wants to bless the church world. He wants to see a move in the church.
Yes.
But He cannot do it until we have the will. The man that laid at the pool for 38 long years, the first thing when Jesus came back, the first thing He said, "Will thou be made whole?" You got to have a will.
Yes, amen.
For God to move in your life. You know that?
Yes.
He'll not intertreated with you. He'll not make you do things. I heard a fellow say one time, if I ever sin and get out of the will of God, he'll reach out there by the hair of my head and pull me back. I said, no, he won't. You're going to be like the prodigal son down in the hog pen, yes. Smelled like a hog, looked like a hog, uh-huh. Would have filled his belly with the sluts that the swine did eat, and no man gave to him. All he had friends as long as he had money, but when his money ran out, he didn't have no friends.
No more friends.
You won't either. And here he is ending up in the hog pen, one of the low-down jobs for a Jewish boy. And the Bible said he would have filled his belly with the swine that the hogs did eat. He wanted to see the bright lights of the city. He wanted to live it up. He knew that his father had to give him his inheritance. That was the sort of, that's the way that they did it back in the days of old. The father would lay up for the children. Every once in a while I'll say, my children, I'm spending my children's inheritance. I had a big bottle of pennies, top bottle of pennies, and my boys got to moving, Billy and Rodney got to moving, and Rodney said to Billy, Billy, that's our inheritance right there. A big jar of pennies, you know.
That's a lot of pennies.
I had to laugh, but it wasn't funny, really. Praise the Lord. But, I don't want to get off of that. God has given us joy in the church. Joy, joy, bells of heaven. And that's why I love the Pentecostal church. Thank God, yeah. We're not ashamed to praise God. Lift holy
Amen.
Hands.
Amen.
Without wrath and without doubting. Right. Praising the Lord because we are Abraham's seed. We have a right to lift holy hands unto God. We are a right to call ourselves the righteousness of God in Christ. He made us righteous.
Yes, he did.
He sanctified us. And that's the people he's coming after, as I said a while ago, without spot, without blemish, without wrinkle. We got too many, if you got any wrinkles, you need to get on the altar and let the Holy Ghost iron them out. Get rid of them, amen?
Amen.
And keep the commandments of God. I know many years ago when I used to preach as a young boy, I preached hard. And we seen the altars filled up from time to time. And we seen people saved and delivered, people healed. I had people baptized with the Holy Ghost and I didn't even have it. But somehow I had something in me that I knew that was beyond my power. It worked,
yes,
too.
Yes, amen.
Toby knows that. Pastor's wife come up one night, laid a hand on her, and she began speaking tongues. The deacon's wife come up and laid my hands on her, and she began speaking tongues. But they never would claim it. Their husbands wouldn't let them. God help somebody that will hinder anybody receiving the baptism of the Holy Ghost with the initial evidence of speaking in other tongues.
Yes.
That's what the Church of God stands for, right?
Yes.
We believe in the whole Bible rightly divided.
Yes.
Amen.
We don't believe in part of it. We believe in all of it.
Amen.
A lot of people say, well, that's done away with. Well, the Old Testament is done away. We got a blood covenant with Jesus Christ. It is a covenant that God has made with the church. And this is a good covenant, brother. If you keep the commandments of God, he said, I'll not permit any of these diseases come upon you that came upon the Egyptians. Now, he said, if you are disobedient, then the wrath of God is going to come upon you. I know it rains on the just and the unjust alike. He said there will be diseases that your physicians cannot heal. We got that today, don't we?
Yeah.
Your physicians cannot heal.
Amen.
Because of disobedience. We've got a lot of people with disobedience in the church today. They come when it's convenient. Oh, come on now. Don't get mad at me. Don't get mad. Get glad. Don't get
Amen.
Bitter. Get better. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I know I'm doing better preaching than y'all are looking at me.
Amen.
Amen. Ain't this word good? Oh, it'll build
yes.
you up.
Yes.
Yes.
It's great to be with you. Thank God for his word tonight. Thank God. And I hope and pray to God we get a president in that will get the Ten Commandments back in the schools. Did you ever notice since they were taken out, the children are carrying guns and knives and everything else to the schools? And we think that's great that the Ten Commandments are gone out of there. When I was in school, I think we had prayer every morning before the class started. You can't do that anymore. They stopped the Word of God, the devil, and his little imps. But I'm so glad tonight that I'm free.
Amen.
Yeah. Free.
Yes.
Free. Free from bondage. Free from sin. Free from the devil. Free from everything that comes at me. Praise God.
Yes, God.
Glad to be a Christian tonight. Glad to be a citizen of the United States of America.
Amen.
And I think about them boys who died and give their blood in the battlefield. I think about those hundreds of thousands of men died. The invasion, I think about that a lot. Tears come in my eyes when I see them burn the American flag. And I see other nations doing that. Oh, right. Let this turn me up. I'm going to tell you, sometimes when I look at the American flag, you know what that red stripes means? That represents the blood of our boys that died.
Yes, amen.
I thank God for Merrill Haggard, wrote a song, "If you're running out of my country, my host, you're running, you're walking on the fighting side of me." You know, President Lincoln got him out of prison for that song. He signed his pardon, got him out of prison. I found that out. Praise God. Oh, yes. Thank God. God has a way, doesn't he? I don't know about you tonight, but I'm happy in the Lord. I'm content.
Yes,
I'm not searching for anything or asking for anything. I would like to have a refilling of the Holy Ghost. How many like to have a refilling?
Yes.
Lord, we need it, don't we? Praise God. It just, some, I don't know how many years ago, 1969 when I came to this church, 2 years after that I was laying flat on the floor here, speaking in other tongues, which I said I'd never fall out, but I did. I never forget that night, that hour. Never forget that revival. I didn't want to come. I did not want to come to this church. But I'm so thankful that I gave my heart and life to God and He led me to the Church of God. We got a great denomination.
Oh, thank you, Lord.
The standards in the Church of God, we're not what we used to be. We've lowered our standards. I know that, and you know that. But we could get a revival going that would build them back. We're going to come to a close. Before I do, we want to have stand. Everybody stand, please. And I'm going to pray for the nation. If you're going to, you can stay seated. We're going to pray for the nations of the world. There's many people listening to me right now. You're lost. You're doomed for hell. Yes, hell's going to be a reality just like heaven's going to be a reality. He said, choose you this day whom you will serve. As Joshua said, for me and my house, we're going to serve the Lord.
Sure.
Why don't you make this quality decision? I think I'm the only preacher that ever said quality decision. Make this quality decision to serve the Lord tonight.
Yes.
No matter what you're going through, you may be in jail or prison. You may be in a hospital or a convalescent home, wherever you're at. There's no distance in prayer. We're reaching the world right now through the means of the internet. Thank God for these great inventions that we have today. Televisions, reaching ever. That's a fulfilling of the scriptures. The Lord will not come except the gospel has been preached to all nations. And I believe it's one end to every nation now. He can come any minute. And I'm going to ask you to bow your head if you're lost. You need to be saved. You need the blood of Jesus to cleanse you. You don't need to shake my hand and sign the church register. You need to get born again, born from above, sanctified and set apart. Getting a good Bible, believing, holiness church, amen. Where they teach the truth and preach the truth. Where they don't compromise. Where preachers are not sophisticated and dignified. where they want to help people and they got a burden for the lost. I got a burden for the lost. This is the whole bottom line. To reach the lost tonight, as I pray for you, I want to see you born again. I don't want to see you just get religion. I want to see you get salvation. Religion is of the world. That's what this whole world's problem is tonight, is religion. Think about it. All of our problems, wars and everything, is about religion. Thank God salvation is of the Lord, and I'm glad I got a good dose of old-time blood, bald hand, clapping foot, stomping church, going devil chase. Salvation tonight.
Yeah.
Woo! Glory to God. Oh, yes, I'm going to the hotline at the whole world tonight. You get joy, you will too, praise the Lord. I'm speaking full of glory. Let's pray for the nation tonight. All of y'all pray with me. I mean, you don't have to repeat this, but I'm asking the sinners and people that need God to pray the sinner's prayer with me. Repeat after me. Dear God in heaven, I'm a sinner. Say it. I'm lost. Come into my heart right now and write my name in the book of life. Sanctify me through the blood of Calvary. I know that Jesus died for me. I have been in church before and I've heard the gospel preached, but I'm not saved. I feel like I'm under conviction right now. And if you are, nobody can come to the Lord except the Spirit of God draws them. And as the Spirit of God is drawing you and you feel like you need God right now, please make that quality decision. Say, Lord, come into my heart. Save me. Save my husband, my children that are lost. Drugs, salvation is of the Lord tonight. Accept Him. And let the blood of Jesus cleanse you. Write your name in the Lamb's Book of Life and make a new creature out of you. The Bible says, if any man be in Christ, he's a new creature. Old things have passed away and all things are new. In Jesus' name, my friend, I believe with all my heart, if you have prayed that prayer in sincerity and mean it from your heart and are willing to become a Christian, God will write your name in the book of life and you can say, I'm a born-again, blood-bought child of God right now. Say it out loud wherever you're at. Lift your hands unto God and thank Him that you're born today again, born from above. You didn't sign my church card. You didn't shake my hand up to the elbow, but you give your heart to the Lord tonight.
Yes.
Amen. Render your heart, not your garment, unto Him. Thank God for those that have given their heart and life to the Lord. And we're going to pray for those that have wrote in, and we got prayer requests laid up here on the table. And everybody that writes us, we lay their prayer request up here, and we pray for them. And we believe that God can heal. He still heals. He still saves. He still sanctifies. And He's still baptized with the Holy Ghost. Don't let nobody tell you He doesn't. So we're going to lay our hands on these prayer petitions. Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray, Lord, for the blood of Jesus Christ, the Son of God, to cleanse those that are in sin, those loved ones, Lord, that are lost and going to hell. Redeem them with your precious atoning blood. We'll serve you all the days of our life. We thank you, Lord, for saving them. And we thank you for forgiving them, even though they may have committed great sins. And I pray tonight, God, that their names right now, as we lay our hands upon them, that they'll realize that all things are possible with God, and they can expect their prayers to be answered in Jesus' name right now. And believe our word tonight. Believe that God hears our prayers. And He'll save you right now.
Amen.
In Jesus' name, He will heal you right now if you'll believe His word. In Jesus' name, amen, amen. Praise God. All right, Don, go ahead and get the church and people some information.
All right.
Please write us and let us know your need.
Yes.
If you got saved tonight, I want to know about it. I want to hear about it. If you got blessed tonight, write a letter. Phone us. Just get in touch with us.
That's right.
We'll call your name out. Amen.
All right.
Glory to God.
Amen. And you know, we're not afraid to get excited around here. We're not afraid to stand up and let the Holy Spirit speak through us.
Yes, thank you, Lord.
Oh, Heavenly God. Touch each and every single one tonight that gave their hearts to the Lord. if you gave your heart to the Lord, if you have a prayer request, no matter what it is, we want to pray for that prayer request with you. Write us here at the Trenton Church of God. Put Attention Pastor on your envelope. Our address is 35 Rorick, Trenton, Michigan, 48183. Just takes a couple minutes. Put a stamp on an envelope. Put Attention Pastor Burgess. Again, that address is 35 Rorick, that's R-O-E-H-R-I-G, Trenton, Michigan, 48183. Visit us on the web. There, you can read what we're all about and how we believe. There, you can see past sermons. Each and every single one that we record gets put on there. Just pick out the month, any month that you want. Click on that month, and those sermons for that month will come up. There is a contact form. You can fill that contact form out, and it comes right straight to us. You've got to fill out each and every single square. There, you can also go to the Give site, the Give page. You can see upcoming events. You can pay your tithes online securely. We have people that have paid their tithes, have given the church a gift online. It's very secure. Nobody. Because it all goes through PayPal. Can get your information. You can look at upcoming events. You can even see some of the photos of the things that we do around here online. If you're looking for a home church, or even a church that you want to come and visit, Sunday nights anymore around here, we're just about the only church that have a Sunday evening service. That starts at 6 o'clock.